This is difficult for my comrades, as you can tell, because they are not in the best physical shape of their life, like me, where I am just in the peak of...
Thank you for asking.
Welcome to Kilauea, a 2-mile-wide lagoon in Ecuador, formed after a catastrophic volcano eruption 738 years ago. And like the locations of many catastrophic events in history, Kilauea has transformed itself into a major tourist attraction for outdoor enthusiasts who visit Ecuador. The word Kilauea comes from the local Quechua language and combines two old Quechua words, kiru, meaning tooth, and toa, meaning queen, the queen's tooth. But for you, it translates into about 30 minutes down and 2 hours back up. You start at the summit and work your way down the windy and sandy pathway, avoiding the horse poop as best you can along the way. While it's not a difficult hike down, you've got to be careful because the steep decline on sand can be a bit overwhelming for some people. The view from the bottom is as beautiful as the view from the top, but the actual decline is deceptive. Since most people stop and take photos along the way, you don't realize just how fast and steep you're descending. It's a 280 meter vertical descent that you've got to take back up, so don't wear yourself out on the way down. And be sure to leave yourself plenty of time to get back up, because that's the real challenge. That is, unless you decide to take the horses back up. So come visit Kilauea. The village, at one point, comprised of just a few homes and a single hostel, but is now developing into a destination in Ecuador worth spending a night or two. Just remember that what goes down must come back up again.